Dear friends, welcome back. This is Nick from educates.tv and today we are going to see how to load a clone of the popular Flappy Bird game to Arduino. Are you interested? If yes, keep watching. 2 years ago, a Vietnamese-based developer released the game of Flappy Bird for smartphones. The game was a huge hit on both Android and iOS platforms due to its addictive gameplay. All you have to do is to overcome the obstacles, which is harder than it looks. Each time you press the button, the small bird gains a little height. What is the maximum score that you can achieve? Leave your high score in the comment section below. Here we have a version of the game developed for Arduino and the ST7735 TFT display that we use in previous videos as well. The code of the game is not mine, it is developed by Themistocles Benetatos, who describes in his blog the coding procedure. Please check it out, it is really interesting to see how this game was developed. Themistocles was also very kind to share the code he wrote with the community, so that we are able to play the game and learn from his code and the tricks he uses in order to achieve that result. As a developer myself, I can see that Themistocles has done a great job. You can learn a lot from his code, which shows what Arduino is capable of doing. You can find the original code in a link in the description of the video. I made some minor changes in the code. The first one is about the button connection. There is no need for an external resistor for the button if we use the Arduino's pull-up resistor via software, as we saw in a previous video. The next change is that I added code in the game to save the player's high score in the EEPROM memory of the 80MB328 chip. That way, the game is going to remember your high score even though you unplug Arduino from power. Now, let's see how to connect all the parts together. The cost of the parts is around $10. You can find links for the parts in the description of the video. The connection is really easy. All we need is to connect the button and the TFT display to Arduino. One leg of the button goes to ground and the other to digital pin 2 on Arduino. Next, we connect the color TFT display. Please check the detailed tutorial I have prepared on how to connect this display to any Arduino board. Okay, now that we have connected all the parts together, it's time to power up the project and see if it is working. Okay, let's try the button. Okay, let's see. Okay, it is working fine. Now we can go to the computer and see the software side of the project. The code of the project uses two libraries, the Adafruit ST7735 library for the display and the Adafruit GFX library. The first time you run the code, this command here, the reset max score, clears the part of the EEPROM where the high score is going to be saved to. If you want the high score to be saved, after running the game once, you have to comment the reset max score call of the function and upload the game again to Arduino. Now, the high score will be saved in the EEPROM and it will stay there until you call the reset max score function again from the code. You can find the slightly modified version of the code in the description of the video. As I said earlier, by studying the code of the game, you can see and understand the tricks that Themistocles used in order to make this game run fast on an Arduino Uno. I encourage you to take some time and read the code as it will help you understand how to overcome some of the limitations of the Arduino Uno. That's how easy it is to load the Flappy Bird game to your Arduino board. That's why I love the Arduino platform. It is an open community which loves to share. The real power of Arduino is this, the community. I will continue to support the Arduino community and share the best of it with all of you. If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I build projects with Arduino, Raspberry Pi, I build robots and simple electronic circuits. I love making things and helping people doing the same. I hope you will join our community. Thank you very much for watching this video and I will see you next Saturday.